I'm Penny. Today, I'll tell you the story called Lost in the Jungle. The next day was Mom's birthday. Chip had a box of chocolate for her. Keeper had made her a monkey at school. Biff didn't know what to get. Biff asked Anina's mom to help her buy a plant. They went into a big greenhouse. The greenhouse was hot, and it was full of plants. "What a lot of plants," said Biff. It's like a jungle in here. I don't know which one to buy." In the end, she found one that she liked. "I'll get this one for Mom," she said. The next day was Mom's birthday, and the children gave her their presents. Mom liked them all. "Thank you," she said. "What a lovely plant." Dad had a present for Mom. It was a plant. "I didn't know Biff had a plant as well," said Dad. "I don't mind a bit," said Mom. Anina came to play with Biff and Chip. "This is from my mom," she said. Wilma's mom came round with a plant too. "Thank you," said Mom. "I love plants. It's quite like a jungle in here." The children went to play in Biff's room. Anina looked at the little house. "Can we have a magic adventure?" she asked. We can if the key grows," said Keeper. Just then, the key began to glow. The magic took them into a jungle. The jungle was full of plants. "It's wonderful," said Biff. "Look at that one. It's 10 times bigger than the one I give Mom." They saw a monkey up a tree. It jumped up and down on the branch. "That monkey looks cross," said Keeper. "I don't think it likes us." "Looks like you," said Chip. The monkey was angry with the children. It shook the branch. Then it began to throw things at them. "We can't stay here," said Biff. "Come on." They ran through the jungle, but suddenly Chip stopped. "Oh no," he said. "Look at this." There was a big snake in the way. "We can't go this way," said Chip. "Come on." They came to a river. There were alligators asleep on the bank. Don't wake them up," said Keeper. "They might get angry." "They might like you for dinner," said Biff. Suddenly, they fell into a big net. It pulled them up in the air. "Oh, help," called Anina. "We're in a trap." The children were hanging in the net. The net was a trap to catch animals. "Help, help," called the children. "Let us down," called Keeper. A man and a lady came out of the trees. They were explorers. Don't worry, said the lady. We'll soon get you down. What are you doing in the jungle? Asked the man. Are you lost?
Yes, said Biff. I think we are.
So are we, said the lady. But then we have been lost for years. She showed them a picture. We are looking for this place, she said. It's called the Lost City. Nobody lives there. It's been lost for years and years. The children looked at the explorers. They wanted to help them find the Lost City. Maybe we can find it today, said Keeper. I don't think so, said the man. We have been looking for years. They came to a rope bridge. Maybe the Lost City is over there, said Biff. Let's go and see. They began to cross the bridge. I hope it's safe, said Keeper. They found a boat on the bank of the river. The boat was full of water. Oh, good, said the explorers. We lost this boat years ago. They got in the boat and paddled up the river. Look at all the alligators, said Chip. I hope it's not their dinner time. They came to a waterfall. The explorer could not stop the boat. The paddle had broken. Look out, he called. We are going to get wet. The boat went through the waterfall. Oh, help, said Anina. I don't like getting wet. Think of the alligators, said Chip. It's better than getting eaten. Behind the waterfall, there were some steps. The steps went up and up for a long way. Nobody could see how far they went. This may be the way to the Lost City, said the lady. Come on! As they climbed the steps, some bats flew past them. If this is the way to the city, I can see how it got lost, said Anina. It's such a long way up. It's the Lost City, shouted the explorers. We have found it at last. The man threw his hat in the air and his wife jumped up and down. I know we'd find it today, said Keeper. Nobody had been in the city for years. There were plants and trees everywhere. Biff pulled a plant out of the wall. This is like the one I give Mom, she said. They went to a big building and they opened the doors. Oh, look! They all gasped. Everything inside the building was made of gold. The floor was gold and the walls were gold. There were some gold steps that went up to the gold throne. What a wonderful place, said Anina. There's gold everywhere. Keeper sat on the gold thorn. A monkey jumped down behind him. Look at me, he said. Look at that monkey behind Keeper, said Biff. Which one is the monkey? Asked Chip. Suddenly, the key began to glow. It's time to go home, said Chip. Goodbye, said the explorers. Thank you for helping us find the lost city. I wish we had a magic key, said the man. The magic took the children home. Biff still had the plant she found in the lost city. I'll put it in Mom's jungle, she said. I know where we can get a monkey too. The end. Do you like today's story? And do you like this story's adventure? Do you scare the snake or some danger animals? See you next time. Bye bye.
是在丛林里迷路喽。这不是 Keeper 去 Chip 跟 Beef 还有 Anina 他们在一艘船上面。哦，还有三种动物哦，你看到了没有？有鳄鱼、鹦鹉，还有一头野猪。他们在哪里呀？会不会发生危险？我们来看今天的故事。明天呢是妈妈的生日 ，Chip 呢准备了一盒巧克力要送给她。Keeper 呢在学校做了一只猴子，而 Beef 不知道该送什么给妈妈，可是他好像已经有一个 idea 咯。那就是他去请 Anina 的妈妈帮他买一株植物，他们一起走到大温室里面。温室里面很热，因为里面种满了很多的植物哦，所以它的温度是有调控的。蒂夫对着阿丽娜的妈妈说：哇，有好多植物哦，这里就像丛林耶，我不知道该买哪一个。有很大株的，也有悬挂在那个屋顶上的，也有是可以放在户外的或是室内的植物，有很多种，对不对？最后呢，他终于找到一个他喜欢的。他说：我决定了，我要给妈妈买这一个。后来呢，妈妈的生日到了，孩子们都把他们准备好的礼物送给了妈妈，妈妈都很喜欢他们准备的礼物哦。她说：谢谢你们。然后 Beef 呢就也把他的礼物送给了妈妈。妈妈跟他说：哇，多么可爱的植物啊 Beef， 谢谢你。爸爸呢也给妈妈准备了礼物了，也是一种植物耶。爸爸跟妈妈说：我不知道 Beef 也是送盆栽给你耶。妈妈说：我一点也不介意，谢谢你们的心意，我很开心。后来阿妮娜来和 Beef 跟 Chip 一起玩，她呢也递给了那个他们的妈妈一个卡片，说这是我妈妈写的，还有送她一盆花哦。Wilma 的妈妈也带了一株植物来了。妈妈说：谢谢你们，我很喜欢这些植物和盆栽，哇，我这里好像丛林一样啊。所有的孩子们都跑去 Beef 的房间玩了。阿妮娜看到她那个魔法的小房子，她问着说：我们可以来一场魔法冒险吗？ Keeper 说：如果钥匙发光的话，我们就可以去了。 就在这个时候，魔法钥匙确实开始发光咯。他们这次要去哪里呢？哇，魔法钥匙把他们带进了丛林耶，到处都是绿色的世界，丛林里面到处都有各式各样的植物啊，灌木丛啊，还有巨大的树木呢。蒂夫说，太棒了，看那个，你看那棵比我给妈妈的那个盆栽还要大十倍高耶。他们在一棵树上看到了一只猴子，它在树枝上跳来跳去的。那只猴子看起来很生气耶，蒂夫说着。我不认为他喜欢我们，切伯则说，诶，看起来有点像你哦。诶，为什么切伯觉得那只猴子像 Keeper 呢？原来啊，今天 Keeper 他也穿黄色的衣服，还有他有黄色的头发，跟那只黄色的猴子是不是有点像呢？而且猴子应该是有领域性的，他可能把 Keeper 当成了另外一只猴子了吧，所以呢他不喜欢他们。结果真的，猴子呢对孩子们很生气，他不喜欢这些小朋友，他开始丢一些植物丢在或是 水果丢在这些小朋友的身上了，他摇晃的树枝，然后他开始跟他们扔东西了。比如说我们不能留在这里啦，来吧，他们就开始跑过了丛林。但是突然之间 Chip 停了下来，不好了，他说，你们看看前面路上有一条非常非常大的蟒蛇，他呢用他的巨大的身躯卷住了这棵树。哎，有几圈啊，1、2、3、4、5、6，哇，又粗又长的大蟒蛇伸着舌头对他们，他们都快吓呆了。他说，我们不能走这条路。切伯说，来吧，我们赶快换一条路走。于是呢，他们来到了一条河边，岸边有鳄鱼睡着了。 Keep 举着他的手指头说，嘘，不要吵醒他们哦，他们可能会生气。 Beep 说，也许他们喜欢你，把你当做晚餐吃呢。突然之间他们踩到了一个陷阱了，他们掉进了一个大网子里面，这个网子把他们拉到空中了。哦，救命啊，阿妮娜一直大叫，救命啊，四个小朋友后来到底有没有人来救他们呢？于是这些小朋友们挂在网子上面，我们陷入了陷阱了，这个网子是捕捉动物的陷阱。于是小朋友开始大叫，救命啊，救命啊。 Keeper 又一直叫说，放我们下来。原来啊， Keeper 呢被这个网子压得最下面，你看到黄色衣服了他了没有？他应该很难受吧。于是呢，有一个男人和一个女人从树上面走了过来，他们看起来像是探险家的样子。那位女士说，哦，你们别担心，没担心，我们很快就会把你们弄下来的。这个男人问这些小朋友说，小朋友啊，你们在丛里面做什么呀？你们迷路了吗？比夫说，是的，我想我们都是。于是他回答说，那个女生回答说，是的，我们也是，我们已经迷路了很多年了。他指了一张照片给他们看，但是呢，我们正在寻找这个地方，失落的城市，没有人住在那里，这个城市已经消失很多年了，都没有人知道在哪里。哇，他们真的是住在这里，有帐篷，还有自己会烧柴火煮热水，还有这个露营用的椅子啊，还有桌子，准备的相当齐全呢。你注意看哦，这个遗失的城市像什么样子？有点像金字塔耶，不知道他们会不会找到。哎，我们继续看下去哦。 这些小朋友们很喜欢探险家，于是他们决定，他们想要帮助他们找到这个失落的城市。 Skipper 说，也许我们今天可以找到他哟。那个男人说，哇，我不这么认为，我们这么多年来一直在寻找，一直在找，都没有找到过。他们呢，就一直走着走着，来到了一座用绳索所做成的桥。哎，哇，软软的，而且细细的，不知道稳不稳哎。Beef 说，也许失落之城就在对面，我们去看看吧。于是他们决定要开始过桥了。Keeper 有点担心，
我希望它是安全的。
也许它年纪小，于是所以它有点害怕吧。于是他们就这样摇摇晃晃的过去了河岸的另外一边。他们在河岸的另一边发现了一条船，船上面装满了水。但是探险家非常的兴奋，说，啊，太好了，几年前我们失去了这条船，我们现在找到了。这位女士呢，用她的帽子把水给捞了出来耶。然后呢， Chip 呢，她在旁边把一些植物给从那一艘船上面拿下来，等一下他们就可以住在上面咯。于是呢，他们搭上了，开始每个人都坐上船之后呢，那个男士开始两边开始划桨。Chip 说，啊，有鳄鱼，我希望现在不是他们的晚餐时间。这就是封面的那张图啊，你看有几只鳄鱼啊，你看到了没有？至少有两只哦，实在是太紧张了。他们就一直滑到了一个瀑布，但是探险家他没有办法把 船停下来，因为刚刚的那个木桨它断掉了，坏掉了。他说，大家小心，一直因为他们一直朝着这个瀑布前进，我们会被淋湿的。船于是就真的穿过了瀑布了。阿妮娜说，哦，帮帮忙，我不喜欢被淋湿嘛。 Chip 在旁边说，你想想看，鳄鱼总比被吃掉好吧。哦，于是呢，那些小朋友还有探险家，那些探险家好像那个女士是不是撑着她一把伞通过了那个瀑布啊，你看到那个影子了没有啊？哇，他们全部的人都通过了瀑布了，而瀑布后面有一些台阶耶，是不是像水帘洞一样，在瀑布里面别有洞天呢？而这些台阶必须不断的往上爬，他们就一起走了很长的一条路，没有人可以知道他们到底走了多远了。那位女士说，哎，这可能是通往失落之城的路哟，来吧，我们加油。当他们爬上台阶的时候，有一些蝙蝠飞过他们的头。啊，安妮娜说，如果这是通往失落之城的路，我可以了解到是如何迷路的，都被吓死了，而且还这么高。终于他们走了一段时间之后，哇，探险家们喊道，这里就是失落之城，跟那张照片一模一样耶，我们终于找到了。这位男士呢，他非常兴奋的把帽子扔到空中，而他的妻子跳上跳下。 Keeper 说，我就知道我们今天会找到他的。多年以来，没有人找到这个城市，而这里呢，到处都是植物和树木。Beef 呢，从一座墙上面拔出了一株植物，他说着，嘿，这就像我给妈妈的那一种盆栽耶，那种植物哦。你兴奋的时候会有什么动作呢？是不是像这两个探险家一样，会把帽子很开心的扔上空中，或是很开心的跳起来呢？接下来他们会进去这个失落之城市吗？哦，他们走到了一座大楼前面了。他们 开了门，哇，看，他们都吸了一口气。天哪，建筑物里面的一切都是由黄金所制成的，地板是黄金的，墙壁是黄金的，还有一些金色的台阶通向了一个金色的宝座。阿妮娜说，哇，多么美妙的地方啊，好漂亮哦，金碧辉煌耶，到处都是黄金。你喜欢黄金打造的家吗？可是我想也有可能会又冷又冰哦，因为是金属制的耶。虽然都是黄色的，而且这个真的是价值连城哦。于是呢 Keeper 呢就往前走，他就赶快去坐到那个黄金宝座上了。有一只猴子从他的后面跳了下来，坐在那个宝座的旁边看着他。 Keep 说，你看看 Keeper 身后面的那只猴子。 Keep 开玩笑说，哪一只猴子啊？原来啊，他觉得 Keeper 还是跟那只猴子长得太像了。于是他就问 Beep 说，你觉得是哪一只呢？突然之间钥匙开始发光了。 Keep 说，是时候回家咯，再见。探险家们说，谢谢你们帮我们找到了失落之城，我们实在是太开心了。我也希望我们跟你一样有一把神奇的钥匙呢。这是他们的丛林探险之旅呢，还真有趣呢。于是呢，魔法钥匙把孩子们都带回家咯。 Beef 还是拥有他在失落之城所拿的那个小植物，但是因为通过了魔法钥匙，所以变得非常非常小的哦。他说，我想把它放在妈妈的那些丛林盆栽里面，而且呢，我也知道我可以在那里弄到一只猴子哦。他就偷偷的指着 Keeper， 还真的很像一只很可爱的金毛猴子呢。今天的故事就讲到这里咯。妈妈呢，得到了妈妈生日呢，得到了好多盆栽哦，她也很喜欢。而且呢，房子呢就好像变成了丛林一样，因为种满了各种的植物啊。喜欢今天的故事吗？今天的故事就讲到这里咯，拜拜。